Hello and welcome to the Gray Room. Today we're going to take a look at my Star Wars Episode 1 figure collection. So I'm going to show you some of the unpackaged figures that we have and each of the packaged figures that I've collected, and then I'll tell you a little bit about how I collected them and then some of the features that the figures have or that they came with in the packages. So let's check it out. Okay, so I'll start with showing you the different packaged figures that I have. And there are 37 different ones that I have that are in the packages. And as you can see on the package, they come with a CommTech chip. And what that is you have a reader, and you put that chip over the reader, and then it gives you quotes and sounds that are supposed to be from the movie. And so right here we have five different styles of battle droid, with, you know, variations of battle damage and different things like that. And then here's some of the Naboo people, some pod racers. And then going back here, we have an interesting one that I have. It's a mislabeled figure. So right here you can see it says Darth Sidious and the label's on upside down. I thought that'd just be kind of fun to have, and because it's obviously supposed to be Senator Palpatine. So then we'll look at the last few figures here, and then we'll take a look at some of the unpackaged ones that I have so we can see the points of articulation, and we'll do a little chip reader demonstration as well. Now here's the figures that I have open. And you can see the little CommTech chip in front of them. And they have a little peg on them that you could stand the figures on also. So I have a couple of demonstrations of that as well. And here's one movie scene pack that I have, the Mos Espa encounter. And I got that specifically to get the Sebulba figure there for that one. Now, whenever these came out, there was such an anticipation for this movie, and there was such a craze over these figures, man. People were waiting in line every time there was a new stock coming in to see what figures were out and everything like that. And we were waiting in line at, like, Toys R Us and Target, and there was a store called KB Toys. And so at these different toy stores, they were having, you know, a release. Like every Saturday or something like that, they would come out, and so everybody would line up and wait in line early in the morning for them. Now, one of the things that happened was somebody noticed that on the packaging right here, you can see that .0100, and on this, it's the same Darth Maul figure right here, and it says .00, right? And so there was a craze on, like, eBay, and you can see right here it's the same figure. And just like somebody was saying, like, oh, the .00 figure, that's a rarity. And, man, you could sell them, you know, $20 or $30 a figure for a short time until finally they figured out, oh, well, those numbers didn't mean that there was a rarity. And so the .00, the .100, I have just as many of each kind. And then so there's also a dot with four zeros and a dot with a 0-200. So there's not really a difference in the rarity of the figure based on that number. Another thing that sent everybody into frenzy is the lack of the Episode 1 logo right here on the Yoda figure. So for, like I said, on just like the other thing on eBay for a while, man, you could sell these for quite a bit of money, and it was figured out that no, that wasn't a rarity after all. So just a couple of things that were kind of crazy during that time. And, you know, like I said, there was five different battle droids. And so that was another thing. Oh, the battle droid with this damage or with that damage or the dark one, you know, or whatever. It sent people, you know, flying after them. And it ended up being like you could just get them all the time anyway. So now this is the CommTech reader. And this is the power button. And you could actually store some of the different chips, sound effects and words into those different buttons, and then it has its own sound effects there if we turn it on. So there's some like lightsaber effects, and then so then these are the chips, and if you put that over that spot right there, that one there's kind of an extended one, but and then so. So each one has a little different, you know, sayings, and the figures that have more than one figure, there's a couple of different things on each chip, kind of like the ones now from the Last Jedi, where they have that in it, and I think that one's a little bit better, because this one kind of sounds like muffled and not really like the person's voice. I think the newer ones sound a little bit better. Now with these figures, they didn't have all the same points of articulation, so we can check this out right here. We have Captain Panaka. He's in a posed position, and you can move at his legs at his hip joint, but not at his knees. That's a fixed pose. And then he twists at the waist, and then he has an extra articulation here in his right elbow that you could move out. Now Yoda, right here, he has actually ball joints on his shoulders. So his arms can actually go up and down and forward and backwards, but he does not articulate at the waist, and only his leg as a whole, altogether, both of them, you know, move up and down at the waist, but you can't move them individually. So a little bit different between figures. And then you had some, because of the way they were dressed, they were just 5 points with the hip joint on the legs, the shoulder joint on the arms and the neck. But basically because of the way they're dressed, you know, other points of articulation aren't available in that. And one of the things I did like about these figures were the lightsabers. I thought they were pretty cool. The handles or the hilts were pretty detailed. Whoops, knocked over Qui-Gon. Well, he's dead anyway, so he's used to falling down, right? But yeah, I liked the translucent lightsabers in that. So that's one of the things that I liked about these figures. All right, so that does it for my Star Wars Episode 1 figure collection. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think of this line of figures? Do you like the Episode 1 figures? Do you have any of these? What do you like about them? What do you not like about them? What about the CommTech chip? Do you like that? Let me know. I always like seeing your feedback. So that does it for this video. Thanks again for coming into the Gray Room. Hey guys, if you want to find some good deals on some of the stuff that I show in my videos, be sure to check out the Amazon.com link in the description bar below. And if you buy something from there, it helps support the channel also. So thanks again for coming into the Gray Room. Be sure to take a look around at some of our other videos, and don't forget to like and subscribe.